Every single dream, I lay each one down at your feet. Every moment of my wandering never changes what you see. I've tried to win this war, I confess. My hands are weary, I need your rest. Mighty warrior, king of the fight, no matter what I face, you're by my side.
Thank you, choir. It's good to know we have a God we could trust in. Amen? All right. Let's open up this service tonight. Let's stand and sing from the chorus book. Number 208, How Great Thou Art. It's 206, sorry. 206 in the chorus book, How Great Thou Art.
I see the sun.
we singing too good to sit down now? I just want to say welcome everyone out tonight. It's great to see everyone out tonight. Welcome to our annual Fisherman's Service for 2019. It's great to have everyone here, especially if you're visiting with us tonight. Let's turn to number 173 in the chorus book. Let's just praise the Lord. For your good singing. At this time, we're going to bow in a word of prayer. Lord, we just thank you for this evening that you've given us, Lord, that we could come together, Lord, to just sing praises to you for what you've done for us throughout the many years of this island as fishermen, lobster fishermen, Lord, as we go out year after year, Lord, and so little deaths that we've had, Lord, and just very few fatalities, Lord, and we just want to give you the thanks and the praise for that because we know it's you and you alone that keeps us safe while we're out there, and we just want to give you thanks for it. We thank you for this evening that you've given us. Lord, we just pray that we will take this time to give you the thanks and the praise that you and you alone deserve. Lord, we just praise that we will, this evening, we will praise the Lord. We ask these things, Lord, in thy very worthy and precious name. Amen. All right, at this time we're going to be favored by Firm Foundation, I'll Never Sail Alone, followed by the choir, Same Power.
I'll never sail alone, though I am headed home. This vessel's not my own, the captain has stepped on board. Thunder and crashing waves can't sink, what mercy made. This ship was built to praise Jesus my Lord.
No,
I'll never sail alone on stormy seas. I have the mighty hand of God leading me. He'll pilot me safely through waters unknown. I will not fear because I don't sail alone.
Promise here, the day is drawing near when I reach heaven's pier, and I'll sail these seas no more. But till I'm anchored safe where heaven's harbor waits, though this boat rocks and shakes, my faith's in the Lord.
No, I'll never sail alone on stormy seas. I have the mighty hand of God leading me. He'll pilot me safely through waters unknown. I will not fear because I don't sail alone.
No, I'll never
sail alone on stormy seas.
Yes,
his hand is heavy, always leading me. He will pilot through waters unknown. I will not fear because I don't sail alone. Pilot me safely through waters unknown. I will not fear,
no,
I will not fear,
no,
I will not fear because I don't sail alone. Sail
of nations.
Thank you, Firm Foundation and Choir. We'll never sail alone in the same power. Two powerful songs right there. All right, we're going to have the quartet, God of Wonders, and then the Aubrey family coming with a special selection.
Jesus is teaching, no to die for our sins.
At this time, the choir is going to come with their last selection, I Can Trust Him.
The joy is there.
We're going to sing How Great Is Our God. Let's stand and sing.
Oh,
I'd like to have something to say, and then we'll have another time of singing.
You can turn the well-known verses in Proverbs 3 if you want, Proverbs 3, 5 and 6. We heard a lot about trusting tonight, and we all know, as fishermen, what he's done for us in the past. And these two verses, they've been reminiscing in my mind, really just right before the meeting until now, well-known verses. And it talks about the future at the ending of verse 6, Proverbs 3, 5 and 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct or make straight your paths. And I was thinking, you know, we got the Lord on our side, especially those of us that believe us in here tonight. I was thinking, I can't imagine going out to sea for 3 weeks, 4 weeks, 5 weeks at a time without having the Lord Jesus living inside of us. We don't get a weekly wage like most jobs around here. And it's like every year, year after year, trip after trip, he just provides, he guides us, he directs us, and we make money. And he's abundantly blesses us on this little island as fishermen. And it's amazing to me, and I often think, especially today, those of us fishermen that might not have living inside of them, it's almost like, well, what hope could you have going out to sea? We ain't guaranteed nothing. We set the traps. The Lord sends the crawfish in. They march. And that's got to be tough. If you're here tonight, if you ain't got the Lord living inside of you, I don't know. It's hard to hope. But when we got him, like these verses say, we can trust in him. He's going to provide. He's going to meet all our needs. Whatever it is, he knows all about it. And in some words of the choir singing tonight and some of the songs, I jotted down some of the thoughts. Greater is he who is living in me. He's conquered our enemies. He's done it all. He's been all the way for us. Don't you know that he's going to keep being with us, guiding us, and directing us? I was encouraged and comforted right before the meeting and during the meeting over these precious thoughts and truths. And the same power that rose Jesus from the grave, if you're a believer, lives in us. The same power that can calm a raging sea lives inside of us. He moves mountains when he speaks. I tell you, I'm overly encouraged tonight and comforted in knowing that we got the Lord on our side, guys. We leave in a few days. And be encouraged. Be encouraged. He's going to take care of us. We have a lot of things that could happen and that do happen. But at the end of the day, he is in control, and he's got our back. So just a few thoughts that's been on my heart.
You know, down through the years, as fishermen, he's been faithful to us. I mean, there's nobody on this island, even the unbelievers, that won't say that God has not been faithful. And one of the songs the choir was singing on God's faithfulness, these verses come into my mind. Lamentations 3, verse 21 says, "This I recall to my mind, therefore have I hope. It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because his compassion fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, saith my soul. Therefore, but I have hope in him." And that keeps us going. I mean, for me, I ain't ashamed to say that I don't like fishing. I used to love it. I don't anymore. I don't like leaving my family. I don't like leaving my church. But it's where God's placed me. And with the hope that he's going to provide for me, he's going to keep me safe, he's going to bring me back, he's going to keep my family safe while I'm gone. With that hope, relying on his faithfulness, I go and he brings me back. And I go and he brings me back. And I go and he brings me back. Year after year, for over 30 years, I've gone, he's provided, and he's brought me back, and he's kept me safe, and my family safe, my community safe, and my See, that's faithfulness. There's nothing more that could be said, but that he's been proven that he is faithful to us. Amen.
Sometimes, you know, you encounter dangers. And I know 3 or 4 times that I had experiences where I actually had one time right down in Pimlico Channel. A shark hit me. And I knew that God had protected me from that situation. And he hit me and backed off. And he was coming again, and he was right to my fins, and you know, I was scampering. And it's been all the times I've had fish taken right off the spear. Back then, used to spear a lot of fish. But I can say, I know that the Lord has protected me. 50 years I've been diving, and he's protected me. I know he's done the same for a lot of other divers in here this evening.
Amen.
And those that are not here, all the guys that and all the churches. He's been so good to me. I can't thank him and praise him enough for how good the Lord has been to me. Anyway, let me continue just adding on to like what our brother Jeremy. I'll continue reading on here. I will bow down toward you, your holy temple. I will praise your name for your unfailing love and your faithfulness. For you have so exalted your solemn decree that it surpasses your fame.
You know, he's been so faithful to us, and we don't deserve it. And we have something to trust in, something to look forward to, some hope, you know, because we know he's going to be there for us. And, you know, we go out on these boats, and as a assembly, you know, we lean on him as his people. And I just want us, as we go out on these boats, I know how hard it is. We get so many frustrations. It's so hard to turn away from him and to look at our own understanding, is what the verses that Brendan read, you know. We have to stay away from our understanding and look to his understanding. And I thought of these verses in Matthew 5:14-16. You are the light of the world. The city on a hill cannot be hidden. Nor do people light a lamp and put under a basket, but on a stand, and gives light to all the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your glory. They may see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven. Just a challenge to all of us as we go on these boats, on these fishing boats. And we be around others. Of course, me and Cassidy's in a different circumstance where we be around people in other communities. But let's let our light show. Let's show that we something different, and we have a hope that is greater than this world.
But I just wanted to share this one with you all tonight, because I thought that this couldn't come on a more perfect day than the day that we have this service. It's from Psalms 107, verse 8. Says, oh, that men would give thanks to the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. And then she goes on to say, dear ones, we go to the Lord with our needs in prayer, but do we take time to thank him for what he has done for us every day? He gives us life, breath, and all things. It's only right that we should give him our thanks in return. And I just thought that was the perfect short little devotion this morning, to just, as we have this service, to give thanks to our God for what he's done for us. And as we've so many have said already, his faithfulness to us. I mean, as Brendan said and others have said, we don't put the lobster there. I've heard Jeremy say it before, and I couldn't agree more. We don't put a single lobster under those condos. God puts every one of them there for us, and we need to give him thanks for that, because he is the one who's worthy. So at this time, let's stand in our closing. And after we finish this song, we want the fishermen to stand, remain standing, all the fishermen and their families remain standing. And we're going to have our two brothers come up and pray for the fishermen and for the families. And we're going to close the service tonight. But let's sing, give thanks with a grateful heart. Thank you. right, at this time, the fishermen and the families remain standing, and we're going to have our brothers come up and pray for us.
I was thinking today, you know, Brother Jeremy said it, I mean, he hit it right in the nail. I don't know too many people, fishermen in here tonight, would probably raise their hands and say they love fishing. Do you? How many? You got a couple. Well, over the years, as you got older, I think that will change. It will change. Well, most of us, when you got older, you start to realize, and like Brother Jeremy says, the more you start to have children, families, and just age in itself, and you just sit there and you say, man, this just, I don't need to be doing, I wish I wasn't doing this anymore. But like Brother Jeremy said, God has placed us there, and that's what we do for a living, and we need to be thankful each and every day for how good that he be to us. How we've heard tonight throughout the service, to trust in him. He's faithful. So many different things. It is true. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for how good you have been to us. And Father, we think tonight as fishermen, how that, Father, we need to be thankful. We need to be faithful. We know that we need to give you thanks, but Father, we need to be faithful as well to you, before we know that you are faithful to us. So Father, help us to be faithful to thee as well, and Father, help us as fishermen to not just as we leave these shores, Father, may we not forget you, may we take you with us. Father, may we take you along beside us each and every day. May we put you first in our lives. Father, may we be an example to those around us that do not have that light, as Brother Lauren talked about tonight. May they see that light in us. And Father, may they come to, even through what they see through us as fishermen and on board these boats, that they see the love of the Lord Jesus. They see the Lord Jesus living in us. So Father, we pray for us as fishermen. Father, we know the dangers, Father, that are all around us each and every day. Father, it's so many things that when you consider that the things that just swim by us that we do not know about each and every day, and how you protect us and keep us safe. Father, we thank you. We thank you for this and how that you protect us and that we don't have too many casualties each and every year, and very little things that we hear about people getting hurt. But Father, we know that you are a God that cares and a God that loves. And Father, we just pray tonight that you would be with us as we leave these shores again, and that you would be with each and every fisherman, Father, and that's just help us to be what we ought to be for thee, and just protect us and bless us and make us a blessing for thee, we pray. Amen.
Let me just add on a couple words to that. Unlike my brother Kachar, I love fishing. Now, I know some, I ain't got a family yet. I mean, I have my mother and father and my sister and my brother-in-law, but I don't have a immediate family that close with a wife and children. But I know it's hard leaving your home. I know for me, even, it's hard leaving and going away from my family. I know from my mother worries too much, but it's hard, and I understand that. But one thing you have to look forward to is coming home, and how great it's going to be when you see your family to come home. And I know that's a great thing and a great feeling when you approach that harbor and you see your family, because the Lord brought you through that. And the Lord is just so great when it comes to all things like that. I was reading in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, one of my favorite verses is verse 13, and a little bit backstory, it talks about the Israelites and how they complained and how they ridiculed Christ, I mean the Lord, and just did all kinds of bad things. And I know as we go out there, sometimes we have them thoughts in our head, we complain, we doubt Christ, but understand this, the Lord has been with this island for many, many generations back. He has provided, he has sustained us tremendously, and we have to give him the glory for that. And bringing us home back to our families, most of all. I just want to just ask everybody to stand, because I know in some way everybody is related to everybody. So we're going to ask a prayer for the family. So everybody, you can stand up. You're related. We all one body in Christ. So let's just stand and ask the Lord's blessing on the family as the fishermen go out. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you so much for you, for being who you are. Lord, we thank you for just providing for us in every which way you do. Lord, we don't deserve it, as lowly sinners as we are. But Lord, you do. You sustain this island in many, many ways, and fishing is one of them. And Lord, as the fishermen go out for 3 to 4 to 5 weeks at a time, Lord, during this season, just be with them, protect them, protect the families, Lord, that they leave behind. Lord, let them, when they just think of the families as they're out there, let them understand that you are hovering above them. You are protecting them. You are guiding them in their everyday life, Lord. You are the great beacon. You are that light, what is just there for them all the time. So, Lord, just be with the families of this island, because everybody is related and to a fisherman. Everybody's concerned about the fishermen, Lord. Let them have that ease of worry, Lord, that you are with us and you are with them also. So, Lord, just protect them, protect us as you only can. And we just ask all these things in your precious and worthy name. Amen.
And we want to thank everyone for coming out. I pray that you've been blessed, as I have. I feel like it was truly great to be here tonight. We just thank everyone. We're dismissed.